Yes, viewers, that judge, that brain dead, blissfully ignorant, power drunk judge today, along with the help of the Crown prosecutor and that social worker, told me that one of the 11 conditions of my release today was that I not do certain things, but really, I don't know if, I don't really know, viewers. If that judge or whoever was responsible for this joke, this joke on paper, I don't know if whoever was responsible for this joke on paper mentioned that I'm not allowed to put on the Jehovah suit and stand in those locations holding the disgusting brainwashing propaganda when the cult members aren't here. I don't see no Jehovah suit, no standing when cult members not around. So I think what I'm doing right now is perfectly acceptable, viewers. You'll recall this individual from a previous episode. Cheryl commented on how he was a David Carradine lookalike, I believe. It's now 7:15, viewers. 7:15 p.m. on Friday evening. The cult members are long gone. While I'm talking to you, viewers, I'm going to be holding the magazines so I can record any discussion I have with somebody who stops to take them. Of course, instead of getting the magazine, you and I both know they're going to be getting one of these, along with my 2 cents. Right, so there are no cult members standing here at present, viewers, which is a good thing, because I've been instructed to not come within 100 meters of the cult members. I'm holding the magazines, viewers. Not within 100 meters of the cult members. So we'll see if I'm being watched right now. We'll see if one of the cult members comes back to this spot so that then they're able to watch me quickly run away, so that I can avoid being jailed again. Let's see if one of the cult members comes to try to bully me away right now with the power of Caesar behind them, now that I'm standing here when they're not here, not violating the conditions of my release. So I'm not violating the conditions of my release, but let's see if there are cult members in the area watching me, waiting to come to my space to then expect me to leave. Let's see if that happens, viewers. I'm going to stand here with the magazines for quite some time, waiting for the cult members with Caesar's authority to come try to bully me out of here. Let's see if it happens. Young people ask.
I'm not young.
That's right, yeah. Maybe this magazine isn't for you then. What about maybe the Awake magazine?
Happiness.
Yeah, the Way of Happiness.
I'm happy.
Have you? Oh, okay. Have you ever studied the Bible with Jehovah's Witnesses? No, you
I
know
like
what?
To study Bible, not to study, but at least once read it.
Okay.
I'm Muslim.
Okay.
But once I read the Quran.
Yeah.
But I think I need to read Bible and Old Testament. At least these
okay.
are the main
yeah,
books,
that's right.
right?
That's right. Yeah, you can really challenge yourself now about what you believe like never before, thanks to social media and the internet and history and yeah. Actually, I'm not one of Jehovah's Witnesses. I'm an ex-Jehovah's Witness. I'm what they call an apostate.
Never
so,
heard of.
Actually, a judge ordered me not to talk to Jehovah's Witnesses today.
Why?
Because when you talk to Jehovah's Witnesses as an ex-member, you can really ask them some questions that they really don't want to have to talk about, like the covering up of child abuse and the failed predictions and the flip-flopping on their policies and everything. So really, I'm a member of what's called the Vast Apostate Army. And the website to go to learn about Jehovah's Witnesses is jwfacts.com. So really, you're welcome to go to jw.org, but if you also want to learn about Jehovah's Witnesses from ex-Jehovah's Witnesses, who will be able to tell you things Jehovah's Witnesses will never even admit, then you should go to jwfacts.com and learn about what it really means to be one of Jehovah's Witnesses, because it's a lot more than just the warm, friendly smiles they show you with their magazines like that. So take it from me. Yeah, what's your name?
Remy.
I'm Stuart, Remy.
Stuart?
Yeah. So when you see me standing here with the magazines, I'm not one of Jehovah's Witnesses.
Okay.
I'm what's called a filthy, disgusting apostate.
What?
Yeah. That's what they call us. That is what they call us. Yeah. A demonically possessed, mentally diseased apostate. That's right from Watchtower literature.
That's cool.
Yeah, it is pretty cool. Yeah.
I think the way is to get into God is through the number of people. Anyone can seek the God.
Right.
Even if in its own way.
That's right.
You don't need any Bible or Quran or
How honest are you being about your search for truth? Because you can always be even more honest tomorrow than you were today and the day before, right?
Yeah. Well,
so
any good words that can lead you, getting you closer to God, is good.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter who's saying that.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter.
I heard a good one a couple of months ago. Somebody said, the meaning of life is to find your gift. The purpose of life is to give it away.
Give it away,
so,
means tell people about it.
How exactly? Tell people, share it, give it away, risk it possibly. For instance, if you found freedom from a certain religion or organization or way of thinking, and you see people who are still trapped in that way of thinking, maybe try to share the freedom you've obtained by helping them achieve theirs. So freedom is a nice thing to give. If that's your gift, if freedom is your gift, giving it away is a nice thing too, but
freedom means
freedom from anything.
Free from your evil.
Your
inside.
You name it. Freedom from drug addiction, alcohol addiction, mind control, food addiction, whatever. Like whatever freedom you achieved, see somebody who hasn't achieved it, and why not? You know. Help them achieve it. So that's what I'm doing. Like the vast apostate army, we've found our freedom from the Watchtower. So with our activism, we're trying to help others achieve the same freedom. And in the process, we risk our freedom. Sometimes we have to go to jail.
Really? Why?
Yeah. But because Jehovah's Witnesses and the police seem to be like this, and nobody can explain it.
But
yeah.
If police sees you here sharing your experience,
if the police saw me here right now talking to you, and one of Jehovah's Witnesses was standing here right now, they would be allowed to take me to jail. They would be allowed to take me to jail based on this list of 11 conditions that I was shown today by a judge. Yeah, they came to my apartment last night. They arrested me in my pajamas, and then they gave me these 11 conditions. So if Jehovah's Witnesses were standing here right now, I could go to jail for violating one of these conditions. One of them is, look, I can't come within 100 meters
of any church,
kiosk, information booth, facility, or temporary display operated by members of the Jehovah's Witness Church. So this is the police. This is what they call Caesar coming to the aid of a religious organization where somebody like me could end up in jail if I violated these conditions. So they're not here right now. So I can be out here now, but if they were here, I might have to get used to being put in a pair of handcuffs again. I was just in the pair last night, so. So do yourself a big favor. Don't start studying the Bible with Jehovah's Witnesses unless it's to educate them.
I thought it's a free country and freedom of
expression. It doesn't look like it.
Is that?
I guess not. Yeah, it's an ongoing thing. I'm hopefully going to find a lawyer and figure out how to prove that again to myself and others watching, that it is still a free country, but apparently it's not free for people who leave Jehovah's Witnesses and speak out against it. They can expect to be put in jail.
Why? The whole bunch of politicians are Jehovah's Witnesses?
That's a good question. I don't know. Or maybe the people that are responsible for keeping the Watchtower afloat. So a lot of interests in organized religions that aren't always up front, you know? There's the figureheads, but then there's who knows who and who knows what behind it all, right? So, but it's a good thing we're living in the information age. Maybe we'll know soon enough.
I like what you do here.
Right, thanks a lot.
It's I'd like to ask you a question.
Sure.
How do you think you be what is your best acquire in your life spiritual journey? Something you can share with me.
I don't know. I don't fully understand the question. I'll answer you. I'm not trying to be difficult. I just want to understand the question. Can you ask me?
What is the message of life to you?
Ah.
From God or from your religion? The most important thing.
Find your gift. Give it away.
Okay. Nice. I like it.
Some people find it early in life. Some people find it later in life. Some people, I hate to say it, maybe they never find it. I don't know.
For sure.
Is that possible? Some
yeah.
people never find their gift their whole life?
No, they just live like animals. Right? Just
I guess so.
Is
so
enjoyment,
yeah.
fun is the
they're captive
whole.
To living like animals or whatever, yeah.
They're just...
What would you say? What gift would you say you found that you're now in a position to give away? That you'd be happy to give away? No thought of reward, no thought of fame or fortune, just the joy of giving it away because of how hard it was for you to find it.
It's a lot of things, but I would say the most important thing is finding love in your life is the most important thing. To come out of yourself and give importance to something outside of you. Like people.
That's right.
Not always think about yourself.
No, of course.
Just share.
Yeah.
Share your wealth. Share your knowledge.
Yeah,
share.
We're saying the same thing. We're saying the same thing, basically. That's right. Yeah. See, if I was one of Jehovah's Witnesses right now, I'd want to put what you just said in my own words to get you to accept my version of what you said. But notice how you and I can just agree. Like, I don't have to tell you exactly how to say that. Like, if I was one of Jehovah's Witnesses, I used to be one. I would want you to put that differently. I would want to show you a scripture. I would want to show you a point from a magazine and make you express what you just said in the way that I prefer to hear it as one of Jehovah's Witnesses. And I did that for 20 years. And that was why I was so full of myself. That's why I thought I had all the answers, because I would manipulate people into saying things the way that were pleasing for me to hear them. And I would think that I would have taught that person something in the process, but how you put it is perfect. How you put it is perfect. That's it.
Well,
give something outside of yourself. Yeah. It's beautiful.
Good.
You're the man.
Good to see
you. You're the man. What was your name again?
R-A-M-I-N.
Rami. Cool. I'm Stuart Rami.
Stuart.
JWFacts.com.
Okay.
See you later. Yes, yours. I wonder if any one of the cult members had a conversation half as meaningful as that one today, while they stood here waiting for someone to ask them what it is to be truly successful. Yeah. That was not true success just now, viewers. That was a missed opportunity. I didn't tell that man how to pray and be heard by God. I didn't tell that man why God allows suffering. I didn't show him John 17, verse 3, etc., etc. So I failed right there, didn't I? Yeah. I needed to place this brochure with that man in order to be able to tell myself that I had success tonight.